Greetings. I am Nestor Timonidis, and I'm going to present you our work for analyzing the mouse mesoconnectome. I'm going to start with one of the original ambitions of the Human Brain Project, which was to construct a large-scale model of the human brain for analyzing cognitive processes down to the level of cells. For such a goal to be accomplished, we need an adequate description of the connectome, the wiring diagram of the brain. In the image to the left, we have a complete description of the mouse connectome provided to the scaling of anatomically distinct areas such as the primary motor cortex and the synaptic axonal densities quantified between the areas. This is what we call the mesoconnectome. Now, if we take the example on the image to the right, there we have like the connectome in the visual cortex of the mouse, and we have like description with regards to synapses and neurons. The other side of the spectrum, the microconnectome. So what we are interested in our study is bridging the gap between the two scales, meaning distributions of cell types like pyramidal tract neurons, for instance, across the brain, and quantified synaptic densities between them, what we call the cell type specific mesoconnectome. Now, our analysis is focused on rodents. Speaking of rodents, a traditional way to map the connectome is through a technique called tract tracing, usually brain slices, and there are like injections of fluorescent molecules into anatomically distinct areas, which we call like the source ones, and then the molecules flow through the axons to the target areas, and the source target connection is being quantified through two photon microscopy and fluorescence. If we take like the slices to the right, they belong to a set of experiments which we call wild type, like non-transgene mice, and the end product is cell type specific. We know connectivity patterns from an area to an area. If we take like the example to the left, they belong to experiments called Cree. They are transgene mice, and we know that when we inject the molecules, they are being expressed in very specific cell types. So we know what's happening on the source, but not what's happening on the target. Still not fully cell type specific. So this doesn't answer our question. So what can we do about it? Well, given numerous studies, we know how important gene expression is to the creation of synapses during the development of the brain. So what if we could acquire high-dimensional gene expression data and use them to probabilistically infer the connectome, so computationally speaking? And for this job, we selected the in situ hybridization approach because it allows, through fluorescence, the quantification of multiple genes spread across the whole brain in the same special scale as the mesoconnectome areas. And the way that we want to start our journey is first by estimating how much connectivity information is present in those kind of data by using them to predict the connectivity patterns. So we have constructed a pipeline. We have acquired high-dimensional imaging data from the Allen Institute in Seattle, both from tract tracing experiments and gene expression data. We have co-registered and aligned them in the same spatial reference space, and we have averaged their signal across structures so that we can make the comparison between areas. We have employed two classical models from the machine learning literature, namely random forest regressors and rich regression, to train them with gene expression data to learn and predict the connectivity patterns as shown by the two matrices. Now, given each experiment, we kind of quantify the correlation between the connectivity patterns of the actual experiment and the ones predicted by our model. So each point corresponds to an experiment. Multiple points per box plot corresponds to the experiments that belong to a data set. Therefore, we have multiple data sets. We have like 14 Cree line data sets and one wild type. And the reason being is that we want to test our model to evaluate its performance when trained with the same gene expression data, how well it performs with different types of connectivity patterns. So you have to make a distinction between the top row and the bottom one. The bottom one corresponds to control experiments, noise data. We notice that the performance is always higher in the original case. Therefore, we make the conclusion that there is some significance in our analysis. And we also have to state that the wild type, on average, has a slightly higher performance than most of the Cree lines shown here. Maybe it's because it's less complex as a data set. The next step was intracortical connections, and we quantify them by taking the average strength of connections from the mouse cerebral cortex to layers from 1 to 6B based on the original patterns and the ones predicted by our model. We compare the wild-type dataset with an indicative Cre-line dataset, and we note that there is no strong difference between the actual and the predicted experiments and between the Cre-line and the wild-type. And therefore, we saw that gene expression data, the ISH ones, are able to capture the tendencies found in intracortical connections. For reasons of time constraints, I will move into our future work. And this was only the beginning. We just established a very quick relationship between the two data modalities. So we haven't answered our question. So how can we infer a cell type specific mesoconnectome? Well, originally we would like to take like the high dimensional data that I showed before, and we would like to extract like based on the molecular profiles, synaptic and neuronal densities, using a probabilistic model such as Poisson-Poem processes. But we're interested in data fusion, so fusing data modalities related to the brain together, right? So we would like to include reconstructed morphologies, as also shown by previous works. Would like to also include the single cell RNA sequencing data and fusion tensor imaging data, fusing them together with a series of techniques called data fusion, and would like to make Bayesian inference for inferring the cell type specific patterns that we're interested in. And with that, I conclude my presentation, and thank you very much for your attention.